وحده لا شريك له، جل عن الشبيه والمثيل والكفء والنظير. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، ووصيه وخليله، وخيرته من خلقه، وأمينه على وحيه، أرسله ربه رحمةً للعالمين، وحجةً على العباد أجمعين، فهدى الله تعالى به من الضلالة، وبصر به من الجهالة، وكثر به بعد القلة، ولم به بعد الشتات، وأمن به بعد الخوف، وأغنى به بعد العيلة. فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين والصحابة أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, the originator and designer of the heavens and the earth. And upon the best of creation, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we send our salutations. Upon him, his family, his companions, and all those that follow them in goodness till the end of times. I see a lot of new faces today because of the new break. Marhaban, marhaban, welcome to Salat al-Jumu'ah. Last week, we covered overall themes of Surah Qaf. And as we are, of course, approaching Ramadan, which is only 80-some days away, Allahumma ballighna Ramadan.
Ameen.
Allahumma ballighna Ramadan.
Ameen.
Allahumma ballighna Ramadan.
Ameen.
I thought it would only be correct and fitting to start to bring about the Qur'an into our lives. As you all know, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'een, 6 months in advance, and in fact really the whole year, 6 months in advance would they start to plan and prepare for the month of Ramadan. And so as we are nearing the month of Ramadan, the month of Qur'an, it's good to reignite the fire of Qur'an in our lives. Surah Qaf, as we mentioned last week, is a powerful surah. A surah that spoke about Yawm al-Qiyamah, that spoke about the ability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring life after death. That's why the surah begins with Qaf. That's what we discussed last week. This week, we're discussing Surah Maryam, which in opposition is a surah that is very latif, very very soft, and that's why Allah begins this surah with Kaf Ha Ya Ayn Sad. What a beautiful way to begin this very very unique surah. Surah Maryam, you can go to every surah and just based off of the surah title, you can get a gist of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants, what message he wants to give you from this surah. Maryam alayhi salam, of course Maryam is not an Arabic name, but when we go dig deep in linguistics, and which we're not going to do in this khutbah, Maryam, it means this name, it means abida, it means amatul rabb, it means someone, Maryam, it means some a worshipper of Allah azza wa jal, a servant of her Lord. That is what the name Maryam alayhi salam means. So the Surah Maryam, and again this is the only surah in the Quran that is named after a woman, after our mother Maryam alayhi salam, it goes back to this concept of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of ubudiyah, true ubudiyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all know of Maryam alayhi salam that she was saliha, qanita, khadi'a, she was someone who was so righteous, who had given her whole life to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for her religion and for the service of Allah Azza wa Jal. Imra'at Imran, the mother of Maryam alayhi salam, in Surah Ali Imran, she says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says regarding this incident, إِذْ قَالَتْ إِمْرَأَةُ عِمْرَانَ رَبِّ إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لَكَ مَا فِي بَطْنِي مُحَرَّرًا فَتَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. The wife of Imran, the mother of Maryam, she said, Ya Allah, my Lord, I dedicate what is in my womb entirely for your service, Ya Allah. So accept it from me. فَتَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And so she wanted to have a child and dedicate that child, which she would assume to be a son, to the service of Bayt al-Maqdis. But when she ended up having her child, it was a girl, Maryam alayhi salam. فَلَمَّا وَضَعَتْهَا قَالَتْ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَضَعْتُهَا أُنْثَى والله أعلم بما وضعت. different قراءة وضعت. وليس الذكر كالأنثى وإني سميتها مريم وإني أعيذها بك وذريتها من الشيطان الرجيم. When she delivered and she saw it to be a girl, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of course knows what is in the womb, it was a girl and not a boy. And the male is of course not like the female, but despite that, surprised to see a girl, she still kept the promise that she had made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that if I have a child, I will put it in your service. So instead of khidmah of Bayt al-Maqdis, Maryam alayhi salam was then put in worship and seclusion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, the major theme of this surah goes back to the name of Maryam alayhi salam, which means someone who worships Allah azza wa jalla, abida. And so we see that this surah is entirely fitting of two things: bishara, glad tidings for those that worship Allah azza wa jalla, and indhar or nidhara for those that are opposite of that and those who oppose and sin against Allah Almighty. And we see this from the very beginning of the surah. ذِكْرُ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّكَ عَبَدَهُ زَكَرِيَّا. You know, the Qur'an is very unique. It's full of gems. It's full of asrar. We read these ayat, but we really don't know what we're reading. The name Zakariya is not an Arabic name similar to Maryam. And the Qur'an, you'll find in many ways, in many instances, Allah tells us the meaning of these names linguistically through the tafsir of the ayah itself. Zakariya actually, it means Dhakrullah, the one who remembers Allah Azza wa Jal. Zakariya, it means Dhakrullah, if we look linguistically deep into what it means. And Allah literally in that same verse, He says, ذِكْرُ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّكَ عَبْدَهُ ذَاكِرَ اللَّهِ. You see how beautiful the Qur'an is. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here, He mentions dhikr, which is again, worship of Allah azza wa jal. رَحْمَةِ رَبِّكَ. And then He correlates that dhikr with the mercy of Allah azza wa jal. Again, worship Allah azza wa jal and you will get glad tidings. So this is the theme of the surah. Worship Allah, you will have glad tidings. Go against Allah and oppose Him, there is a warning for you. Bishara and nidhara. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you see the same theme throughout the surah, this very beautiful surah, Surah Maryam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards the end, for example, He says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدَّا. Different qira'ah, وُدَّا. As for those who believe and do good, the Most Compassionate will certainly bless them with love, genuine love. Wudda, everyone will love them. Who doesn't love Maryam alayhi salam? Who doesn't love Isa alayhi salam? Subhanallah. So if you are a worshipper of Allah azza wa jal and you dedicate and you take this maslak, a maslak of those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the glad tidings for you, that people will love you. If you dedicate yourself and you attach yourself to Allah azza wa jal, immediately you see that the ayah after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبَلَهُمْ مِنْ قَمْ هَلْ تُحِسُّ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ أَحَدْ أَوْ تَسْمَعُ لَهُمْ رِكْزًا. He tells us the glad tidings of those who dedicate themselves to Him Azza wa Jal. And then immediately He follows it up with a warning. He says, imagine how many peoples and how many nations we have destroyed before them. Do you still see any of them or hear even from them the slightest of sounds? You see, glad tidings and a warning. Again, further, go back a little bit more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the same surah, يَوْمَ نَحْشُرُ الْمُتَّقِينَ إِلَى الرَّحْمَنِ وَفْدًا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on that day, He will assemble all those people that have taqwa, all of the muttaqeen, and they will be brought to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as guests. وَفْدًا. اللَّهُمَّ اجْعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ. Again, glad tidings for those who dedicate themselves to Allah azza wa jal. And you see in the opposite, immediately after that same verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَنَسُوقُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ وِرْدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, we will drive the sinners towards Jahannam like herds of cattle are driven towards water. وَنَسُوقُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ وِرْدًا. You see again, glad tidings for those that worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and them being blessed with karamat and blessings in this life before the akhirah. And the opposite, for those that oppose Allah Azza wa Jal, they will be warned. And this is what they will deserve. More so in the surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you all know, many in the surah you see وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِبْرَاهِيمْ وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مُوسَى وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ From وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says إِذِ انْتَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Maryam alayhi salam, how she withdrew herself from her family and again was in seclusion to worship Allah azza wa jalla. And you find this theme not just in this surah but also in the surah before with Ashab al-Kahf. So she worshipped Allah Azza wa Jalla, she dedicated herself to Him, and then what did she get? Ikram, karamat. She was given many miracles. You dedicate yourself to Allah Azza wa Jalla, you will be given glad tidings. In this dunya, even before the next. Some examples of those miracles that she was given. كُلَّمَا دَخَلَ عَلَيْهَا زَكَرِيَّا الْمِحْرَابَ وَجَدَ عِنْدَهَا رِزْقًا Every time Zakariya alayhi salam would enter upon Maryam alayhi salam, he would say, SubhanAllah, where is all of this rizq coming from? Where is this food coming from? Where is this coming from? And if you ever get the chance to visit Masjid al-Aqsa, they tell you where exactly that mihrab was, which is incredible that they have it known until today. She was given that as a miracle. She was also, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاكِ وَطَهَّرَكِ يَا مَرْيَمْ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ She was chosen over all of the women of the world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said about Maryam alayhi salam, وَجَعَلْنَاهَا وَبَنَهَا آيَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made her, Maryam, and her son Isa alayhim as-salam, a sign for the worlds, and particularly for the people that they were sent to, the Jews, Banu Israel. And you see that this surah is very well connected to the surahs before. Surah Al-Isra, which comes before Kahf and then Maryam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and another name of that surah is Banu Israel. Allah talks about the punishment of those people that go against His commandments. You'll see in Surah Al-Isra, it talks about many of the commandments. وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِعِلْمٍ وَلَا تَقْرَبُ الزِّنَا وَلَا 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 All of these commandments, and they went against it. And in Surah Al-Kahf, we see the incident of Dhul Qarnayn. And those same people, their last warning was the sending of the Prophet Isa alayhi salam. And after him, there was no Prophet sent to them. Because خلاص, they were no longer deserving of that risala. They were no longer deserving of it. And that situation that those people were in and the time that Isa alayhi salam and Yahya alayhi salam was sent to is very similar to the time we live in now. We see in the last verse of Surah Al-Kahf, أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَن يَتَّخِذُوا عِبَادِي مِن دُونِ أَوْلِيَاءَ إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا جَهَنَّمَ لِلْكَافِرِينَ نُزُلًا قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا Who are the losers, Ya Allah? الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسِبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا They were so deeply involved in materialism. Very similar to today's culture. Very similar to what we have in the West. They were heavily influenced by the Romans, copying them. Look at all of the Muslim countries. Look at the rich tradition and culture we have. And yet despite that, we go to our own countries and even us ourselves. We want to attempt to copy the West, copy the West, copy the West, and lose our own morals and lose our own tradition. Copying the Romans, materialism, even being away and distant from religion, nihilism, and just being obsessed with the dunya. And so this is very similar to the predicament we are in. And then this people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent Isa alayhi salam, and He of course sent Yahya alayhi salam. Why? Isa alayhi salam was sent without a father. His mother, Maryam, was a virgin. So this was a miracle birth. And even Yahya alayhi salam, where his parents were very, very elderly. قَدْ بَلَغْتُ مِنَ الْكِبِرِ عُتِيَّا Very elderly. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed them two different miracles for them to begin to believe in the unseen. So again, you see this very beautiful surah, Surah Maryam, talking about worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, true ubudiyah, true submission to Him, and doing that through the means of what? Glad tidings for those who worship, indhar or nidara for those that go against and oppose Allah azza wa jal, and then hudwa, sending us examples of those people that we should follow as true worshippers of Allah azza wa jal. We see the example, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ إِبْرَاهِيمْ مُوسَى إِسْمَعِيلْ إِدْرِيسْ All of these beautiful prophets that are mentioned in such a rhythmic way, we see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions of them certain qualities and characteristics. That if we have these, we will also be true worshippers and people who submit to Allah Azza wa Jal. We'll go over them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes them to be people of ikhlas. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مُوسَى إِنَّهُ كَانَ مُخْلَصًا وَكَانَ رَسُولًا نَبِيًّا
They didn't care about anything else other than Allah Azza wa Jal. They worshipped Allah Azza wa Jal and they had true ikhlas. Another thing that they had. Ya Yahya, خذ الكتابة بقوة. And again, I'm reading all the ayat that are in this surah, nowhere else. خذ الكتابة بقوة. They were people that took the book, they took their religion, they took deen seriously, they took it with strength. People of sujood, they were people who did sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خَرُّوا سُجَّدًا وَمُكِيًّا. They were people that went to sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also described them as فَاصْطَبِرْ لِعِبَادَتِهِ. They were people that had إِصْطِبَارْ لِلْعِبَادَةِ. إِصْطِبَارْ لِلْعِبَادَةِ is different than إِلَى الْعِبَادَةِ. Why? How? Or عَلَى الْعِبَادَةِ. Imam al-Zamakhshari, he discusses this. It's like when you wrestle someone. He's trying to tumble over you, you're trying to tumble over him. That's the way a believer is with his nafs. He's tired, but he still wakes up for Salat al-Fajr and goes to the masjid. He's tired, but he still forces himself and pushes himself to fast on Mondays and Thursdays. He's tired. But then, he's doing istibal. He's pushing back and forth with his nafs. This is the quality of the person who is an abid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like Maryam alayhi salam. And another quality that they had, and this is frequently mentioned in this surah, they were people of salah. Abu Ismail alayhi salam, وَكَانَ يَأْمُرُ أَهْلَهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ. He would command his family, of course, he would be someone of prayer, and he would command his family of prayer as well. And you find, subhanAllah, the opposite of this is mentioned in this surah as well. Those were that were deeply, you know, involved in materialism, and they got lost in their shahawat. وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْغَوْنَ غَيَّا. You'll find that one of the biggest restrictions that comes between you and your relationship with salah is اتِّبَاعُ الشَّهَوَاتِ, following your desires. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our desires in line with what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent with. Until his desires become in line with what I have been sent with. Ya Allah, make us from them. They were people of humility. We find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing in the beginning of the surah, how did he call out to Allah azza wa jal? Nida'an khafiyya. He called out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humbly. He knows Allah is going to hear him. He calls out humbly with Allah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were people of dhikr, literally the second word of this surah. Also something to mention, if you notice the surahs that begin with saad from the huruf qat'iyya, they always mention dhikr. Saad wal qur'ani dhil dhikr. Same thing for an instance in alif lam mim saad, and over here as well. Kaf ha ya ayn saad dhikr. Allahu a'lam, there might be something there. Also, another quality that these people who worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they had, is that they had respect towards their parents. If you look at the ayat related to Ibrahim alayhi salam, many instances, and when he's calling out to his father, what does he say? Ya abati, ya abati, ya abati, ya abati. Calling him with such humility. This is the characteristic of someone who worships Allah. He doesn't be arrogant and proud, and he shows off in front of his family and his parents. But rather, he is someone who is kind, who is humble in front of his elders. Ya abati, ya abati. And in the opposite, Ibrahim alayhi salam, what did he say? قَالَ أَرَاغِبٌ أَنْتَ عَنْ آلِهَةِ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ. The last thing he mentioned was Ibrahim. There's a lot more I wanted to mention. The time is short. So أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم والصلاة والسلام على صاحب جوامع الكلم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. If you have space in the rows ahead of you, please fill them in. Even if you want, you could start filling up this row from now. Please, if you see space in the rows ahead of you, please fill them in so that the people outside can come inside. Last thing I want to mention before I end this second khutbah, bin Allah ta'ala. We see that this surah, Surah Maryam, it talks about worship of Allah Azza wa Jal and the other things that I discussed. Why? The question is for all of us here today, and if you leave with this, alhamdulillah, I'm glad. Why did Allah Azza wa Jal use Maryam alayha salam for the prime example of worship of Allah Azza wa Jal? Didn't Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam worship Allah? Didn't Yahya, Zakariya, Isa, Ismail, didn't all of these prophets worship of Allah? Why did Allah name this surah after Maryam alayha salam? Why is this surah centered around Maryam alayhi salam when it's talking about worship of Allah Azza wa Jal? Why a woman and not a man? Because the righteousness of a society is due to the righteousness of a woman. Look at every single home. Who is the one doing tarbiyah of the children? The mother, the woman. The woman is the first brick of society. And when you see a woman is righteous, you will find, if you find the woman of a society to be righteous, you will find that community and society to be righteous. Subhanallah. This is the strength and power of a woman in Islam. This is the strength of Maryam alayhi salam, our mother. And this is exactly why, and I'm not going to go into two details before I get in trouble, this is why the West has targeted the woman. This is why the West has targeted with different ideas and concepts and this, that. Because they know if the woman falls from the Muslim household, the whole household will fall. If the Muslim woman falls from the Muslim community, the whole community will fall. So I encourage my women, my mothers, my sisters, to be strong and hold on to your faith and be like Maryam alayhi salam and take her as an example. And for us men, to encourage that and to blossom them like flowers and to water them and to be kind to them like we should be. Who would we be without our mothers? Subhanallah, our first exposure to love in this world is through the lap and the hands and the care of our mothers. Even when we look at divine love, when the way we recognize how Allah Azza wa Jalla loves us, for many of us, it's how we feel towards our mothers. Knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves us and cares for us, we look at the example of our mothers. And this is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallu alayhi, he beautifully drew this example when he was with some of the companions and they saw a mother was looking for her child, and when she finally found her child, she brought that child close. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the companions and asked, well, could you imagine this woman, this mother who just brought her child close, to ever want to throw her child into the hellfire? They said, of course not, Ya Rasulullah, of course not. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, using the mother as an example, he said, Allah is more merciful to His servants. Allah is more merciful to you and I than our own mothers are. This is the power of a mother. This is the power of Maryam alayhi salam. And this is why Allah used her as this example for prime worship. What it means to be a true abid and abida of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allahumma ahyi qulubana bi dhikrik. Allahumma ahyi qulubana bil Qur'an. Allahumma ahyi qulubana bil Qur'an. Warzuqna thabata ala ta'atik. Allahumma ja'al al Qur'ana rabi'a qulubina wa nura sudurina wa jala'a ahzanina. Allahumma ja'al al Qur'ana hujjatan lana wa la taj'alhu hujjatan alayna. Allahumma ja'alna mimman yaqra'uhu fayarqa wa la taj'alna mimman yaqra'uhu fayazillu wa yashqa. Allahumma warzuqna bi kulli harfin min al Qur'an halawa wa bi kulli kalimatin كرامة وبكل آية سعادة وبكل سورة سلامة وبكل جزء جزاء. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا. There is a dua request. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show His mercy upon brother Musa Ash'ari. He was someone who established the Nashville Muslim community, and inshallah his janazah will be 2:30 at the Salah al-Din Center. Again, 2:30 at the Salah al-Din Center, the Janazah Cemetery. Thank you. 2:30 at the Salah al-Din Cemetery for the brother Musa Ash'ari. We say Inna Lillah wa Inna Ilayhi Raji'un. We ask Allah Subhanahu wa Taala to shower him with mercy and to give ease to his family and patience. Aqim as-salah. This one is.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
قل لا إله إلا الله استووا واستقيموا واعتدلوا.
Fill in the gaps in the rows ahead of you. And if you have your cell phones on, put them on silent. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى، سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله، إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى، ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى، سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى، الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا، قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى، بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير، والآخرة خير وأبقى، إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت، وإلى السماء كيف رفعت، وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت، وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت، فذكر إنما أنت مذكر، لست عليهم بمسيطر، إلا من تولى وكفر، فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر، إن إلينا إيابهم، ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام.